So last month, I got certified as an application architect, and I've been working with cloud for only less than a year now. And in this video, I want to try and explain exactly how I went from knowing nothing in cloud to becoming an application architect in less than a year. Hey, I'm Asla. Welcome to another video. This will be my first addition to a new series that I'm starting here on the channel called Off Premise. So if you want to see more cloud related videos in the future, make sure to subscribe to the channel. So before we jump into the video, I want to try and clear something out here. I know there are a lot of titles out there depending on what cloud you're working on. There is application architect, solutions architect, cloud architect. Most of these titles sounds more or less the same, and in some cases their responsibilities are somewhat common too. So I want to give an overview of what these titles mean before we see how we can get one of them. So who's a cloud architect? Cloud architect is very much a client-facing role. So they basically talk to clients or customers and try and understand what their problems are, implement solutions according to the client's needs. So they program, design larger architecture, or even work with the organization to understand what their problems are and what kind of cloud services they can use in order to solve their problem. So what does a solution or an application architect do? We also have a similar job to a cloud architect in some ways. We also interact with the customer and try and understand what their needs are while they try to transfer or migrate all their services into cloud. According to a survey, only 30% of today's companies are on cloud and rest of them are on premise. So when they try to finally migrate to cloud, we also help them understand what their business needs are, what their problems are, and try to design architecture and implement solutions according to their business needs. So there is a slight difference between a solution and an application architect, and I found this amazing explanation on Stack Overflow given by someone. I will leave the link below the like button. If you're still curious, you should check it out. So to become an architect in most clouds, you need to pass some prerequisite certificates and have some hands-on experience. For example, in AWS, there are different levels of certifications. Depending on your experience, you can be an associate solutions architect or a professional solutions architect. So they recommend 1 or 2 years of experience in order to attempt these exams. So these are recommended years of experience. It does not mean that you need these many years of experience to attend these exams. So in Salesforce, in order to get an application architect or a solutions architect title, you need to pass a certain number of prerequisites certificate. Usually there are somewhere between 3 to 4 certificates. Once you pass them, you automatically get the credential of an architect. So my number one strategy to passing these many certificates in a short amount of time is I try to take these exams in a certain order. So once I first look at a certificate, I go through the topics what they're covering, and when I finish a certificate, I try to go for the next one which has a similar topic to the previous one. So most of the certificates have some similar topics or overlapping knowledge. So if you finish a certificate and go for a next certificate which covers a similar topic, it's easier for you to transfer that knowledge and it's less studying in a short period of time. So I spoke about this in my previous video. Certificates does not equal to the amount of knowledge or experience someone has, but the certificates are a great way for you to get a high level knowledge of the whole platform or the cloud you're working for. And when you're finally working on a project and when the customer has a need or a problem, you have the knowledge to suggest a solution and eventually implement them, and rest comes with experience. So especially if you're someone who's trying to land your first job or trying to get into cloud, having the certifications help you really get into that interview at least. But I see a lot of people wants to be an architect these days, at least online. I see a lot of people who was trying to become a cloud architect. I don't know, is it because the title sounds fancy or there are a lot more opportunities for architects? I also see a trend of developers who's trying to get into cloud straight wants to be an architect. But if you're a developer who has some coding skills and who likes to build stuff, I would recommend you to become a cloud developer first and then go into an architect path. Because if you're a developer and once you develop in cloud, you get a fundamental knowledge or more vast understanding of how the platform works and how different services work. And when you eventually move into an architect path, you will be having a much more high level knowledge than someone who straight became an architect. But it does not mean that if you're not from a coding or programming background that you cannot be an architect. A lot of the things a solution architect does can be trained on and can be learned from these certificates and different online platforms available. But I think when a developer wants to become an architect, it's best to become a cloud developer and then go to an architect path, because it only complements towards their architect journey. So if you found this video helpful, make sure to like and subscribe, and you can talk to me on Instagram, Twitter, and until then, I will talk to you in the next one. Cheers!